Let's say that you've collected an important metric for two versions of a design, A and B. These two columns of bricks represent data for A on the left and B on the right, with the green brick showing the mean values that we measured. Now, if we measure something where bigger is better, such as conversion rate, not something where smaller is better, like time on task, then clearly design A is the best and should be launched. But not so fast. Yes, the green bricks show the means, but there's always a margin of error in any measurement data, so let's add that. Now, the yellow bricks show the confidence intervals. This means that the true value lies somewhere within that area covered by yellow and green, but the green isn't necessarily the exact true value. So it could easily be the case that the true value for A is down here, while the true value for B could be up here. So in that case, B would be the design we should launch. What to do in this situation? The statisticians will say, we cannot make a decision because we don't have statistically significant data to prove that A is best. However, not making a decision is also a decision, because this means that we will keep using the old design and lose out on any business improvements that would result from launching a better design. So we need to do something else than just give up. The second answer you'll get from a statistician is that we could collect more data to narrow the margins of error for the two measurements in the hope of now having a statistically significant result. The problem is that bigger data sets are very expensive to collect. Even if we're doing an A-B test with analytics that are kind of free to collect, it's only free in terms of money. There's a big opportunity cost from having to wait for a long time while the additional data is being collected. First, we are still suffering from using that old design instead of something better. And second, while keeping the old A-B test running, we may be prevented from testing other design ideas that could provide other lifts to the business value of the product. Let's say it costs $200,000 to collect more data. If we're working on a website that's worth $100 million per year, and we're expecting to gain 1% by picking the best design option, that means it's worth $1 million to get the decision right. So, spend $200,000 to gain $1 million. Let's do it. But what about if we're working on a website that's only worth $10 million per year? In that case, our hope for 1% improvement is only worth $100,000, but we would have to spend $200,000 to gain that $100,000. Not worth it. In this case, we have two options. One is to go with the data anyway, even if it's not significant. After all, the mean values are our maximum likelihood estimates, so it's more likely than not that A is indeed the best design. A detailed statistical analysis will tell us exactly how much more likely this is. But for the sake of argument, let's just say A is 60% more likely to be the best. So we'll launch design A at a 40% risk of being wrong. This is still better than doing nothing because we'll usually be right. And if we're wrong, we'll usually not be very wrong because it's quite rare that it's simultaneously the case that A is at the bottom of its confidence interval and that B is at the top end of its confidence interval. But I actually prefer a second option, which is to stop letting the numbers dictate the solution. Unless the numbers are clear, it's better for us to rely on qualitative insights, maybe from user testing, or maybe from heuristic evaluation, or other use of our UX expertise. A talented UX professional will often be able to analyze qualitative data and form a reliable judgment as to what design is best. If this UX judgment gives us a strong preference for design B, then let's use B. Strong qualitative information should overrule weak quantitative information. Now, on the other hand, if our judgment based on qualitative data is that we can't really tell which design is best, then we're back to square one, and then the weak numbers are the best we have. But in many cases, if you have insignificant quant data, then turn to qualitative UX insights to drive your design decision.